I'm Gopala Anumanchipalli, and I am a speech scientist with the Department of Neurological Surgery at UCSF. And one of our goals is to create technology that can help people without the ability to speak communicate by directly reading from their brain. So the current available technology for neurologically impaired people is to have them control a cursor on a screen to string words letter by letter. The problem being, even in the best case, it's about at the rate of 10 words per minute, which is far less than the 150 words per minute that we speak in natural speech conversations. So that was our motivation going in to decode speech directly from the brain. And we believe a technology that directly decodes the speech from the brain would be intuitive to use for a user. And because it has low latency, the user might feel it easier to adapt to using such a technology. We are recording from the speech centers of the brain, basically the sensory motor cortex, which is responsible for articulating the vocal tract. We are recording from the IFG, which is like the Broca's area, which is involved in the planning-like activity, and the STG, which is the perception area. The algorithm we use, we call it a biomimetic approach simply because we are mimicking essentially the human function of how we produce speech, in that we use the brain to control the vocal tract articulators, which then in turn produce speech. And our algorithm essentially mimics the same technique, where we have a cascade of two decoding pipelines, where one, we translate the neural recordings that we have into an articulatory feature representation, which are then converted to acoustic speech signals. The work was initially supported by the Director's Award to Dr. Chang, which was a high-risk investment into producing, understanding the basis of speech production in humans. And that was continued throughout other grants from the Brain Initiative that helped us proceed with this extremely ambitious. And at the time that we were engaged in this research, there was no scientific confirmation that it was possible. So now we are glad that through the funding that we got from the Brain Initiative, we have converted the scientific problem into what now is an engineering problem, which can be tackled much easier.